What are the new trends in IoT and what are NEC investing right now?
Okay, as you can tell, I mean, through this event, the IoT, I should say, at the peak of hype. But the IoT by itself will not necessarily give the best benefit. Actually, almost every 2 years, we have a new buzzword in these industries. But when we have the IoT, the old buzzword, such as the social networking, the cloud computing, the big data analysis, they do not disappear. Actually, we will combine all of those technologies into one piece so that we can get the benefit by applying, once again, the combination of the cloud computing, big data analysis, artificial intelligence, and IoT to transform the various industry.
That's all different ways of people interacting with technology.
That's correct. But in a sense, it will change, it will transform in a digital way, the various industry, like financial institute. Then when it is applied to the finance, it's a fintech. And when it is applied to the agriculture, it's agritech. And when it is applied to the cities, that's govtech. So that we can think of many tech stuff. But again, important thing is we need to apply not only the IoT as a standalone technologies, we need to combine with other the information technologies. So that as NEC, we are working on the different areas almost as an equal emphasis.
And what can people expect of these new developments?
Okay, actually the virtual reality or the augmented reality will be the next big thing. You have already seen those things applied in the entertainment area, but it is a kind of common practice these days.
It's just Pokemon Go right now.
Yes, exactly. So that the new technologies, the first deployed in the entertainment areas, then it will come to more fundamental services and more serious, more business like the environment.
And in this more serious environment, what are the possibilities? And what are the possibilities that NEC is working right now?
Actually, we have one demo showing the virtual reality or the augmented reality applied to the retails. So I'd like to show the demo here.
Thank you.
Actually, what it's showing is that we are using this tablet as the alternative to the eyeglass. But actually, when the barcode is applied to this the sensors, it will show the in a sense the augmented reality based on the previous choice. Actually, based on this augmented realities, now you see the keypad. On the arms, so that the virtual keypad can be actually used when we press one of the switch. So you will see the input screen for the customer feedback, so that it can be applied. It is an example applied to the retail business, so that when people choose the materials, they can get the immediate feedback to the merchandise.
So he gets information about it, or some data, some information about the thing he's seeing right now.
That's correct. So that based on their choice, that they have already seen the details, the detailed information about this product, and then they can give the additional feedback by pressing the other buttons. So it is the interaction with the real world. So the very key essence of the IoT is the connection between the cyber world and physical world. So that using the virtual reality or the augmented reality, we are connecting the cyber world and digital and the physical world.
They're all the same.
Yeah.
Right here with us.
That's right.
Can you see other kinds of applications of this kind of service?
Actually, as I mentioned, it can be applied to the more and more fundamental services, the not really fancy or the entertainment type things, like the government services. Yeah, to provide the matching service between the social care service, the caretakers, and the recipients, that we could apply this type of a sort of gaming experience, a type experience for those otherwise the DAO.
Is it already commercial?
We are still in the proof of concept the stage, but we are almost ready. The technology-wise, it is always a big issue. I mean, how to build the business models. So that's something we are working on right now.